adding music and sound effects can really help bring your Scratch projects to life. But if you want to avoid some rookie mistakes, you're going to have to learn about timing. Scratch has a built-in library that contains hundreds of audio clips. And if you can't find what you're looking for, you can also find millions of sound effects and music clips on the internet. But controlling sounds can be a little tricky for new Scratchers. Once you load a new sound into the Scratch editor, you can trigger it to play using one of these two pink sound blocks. When you click each of these blocks individually, it sounds like both of them do the same thing. The difference becomes obvious, though, once you add a little more code. The play sound until done block will stop your code from progressing to the next block until the sound is finished playing. This block is perfect for making background music, but it can really mess up complex projects where you're trying to synchronize audio with animations. The start sound block triggers a sound effect, then immediately jumps to the next block and continues executing code. This makes it perfect for adding sound effects to your animations, but there are times when it can create headaches. If you want to create repeating background music in your project, for example, you'll want to put your music track in a loop. But if you use a start sound block, your audio will start up, then immediately restart, and restart again.
I feel the liftoff. The clock has started.